Hello friends, this is Karthikeya Singh working as an assistant professor in the School of Management Sciences, Varanasi. In previous lectures, we have already covered different types of research, and today we are going to start a fresh lecture which is going to cover research process. So I have divided the entire lecture into smaller lectures, and in one lecture I'll cover one step of that research process. So let's begin with the lecture. We are into this first unit and we are going to cover the fourth topic, that is research process. People have already covered introduction, objective of research, research types, and today we are going to cover research process. So let's start with the first step. First step is formulating research problem. This is formulating research problem. Second step is review of literature. Third step is development of working hypothesis. Fourth step is preparation of research design. Fifth step is sampling design. Sixth step is data collection. Seventh step is execution of the project. Eighth step is analysis of data. Ninth step is hypothesis testing. And 10th step is generalization and interpretation of data. And 11th step is preparation of the report. Now, we are going to cover it one by one. Only suggestion at this point of time is you have to mug it up, the entire steps, and you have to keep this sequence as it is. You are not expected to shift the position of these steps. Means if step one is formulating the research problem, you'll have to write in the step number one, formulating of research problem. In step number two, review of literature. Likewise, the steps which are mentioned here, you have to write it as it is. You are not going to manipulate with the position of a particular step. So before moving ahead, just I'm going to give you a glimpse of the entire research process, and one by one in different lectures I'm going to cover one step at a time. So for this particular lecture, I'm going to give you a brief introduction of the entire research process, and it is in formulating of research problem, we usually identify problem, the problem on which we are going to work. So we identify the problem in formulating a research problem. It has a stepwise process, and in this we just take care of stipulated procedures to come out with a research problem. Means we try to reach to a specific problem out of several problems. So this particular step is for reaching to a research problem. Second step is review of literature. On the basis of problem which is we have identified, we start doing literature, and in this literature review we try to study all the available literature related to our research problems. We are not expected to start studying anything which is available in the market, so we have to stick to the literature which is relevant to the research problem, which is material is expected to be studied, and we have to create a database. I'll show you with a practical example. Development of working hypothesis is basically an assumption for the entire research, on the basis of which you are going to study the entire research work. Preparation of research design. In preparation of research design, you are going to solve your basic questions: what to do, when to do, where to do, how to do, and by whom this particular work is going to be done. So what, when, where, how, by whom questions are going to be covered in preparation of our research design. So this is particular research design is going to create a background work for your entire research, and through this background work you are going to do research on the basis of that. Sampling design is basically we first ascertain our population, and out of that population we select a representative data, that is sample. There is a specific process to select sample. I'm going to elaborate at the time of sampling design step. Collection of data, several options are there to collect the data. Generally we are going to do it through survey method. And then different methods are there to do this survey. So questionnaire is going to be serve the purpose, and how this questionnaire is going to be formed, and what types of questionnaire are there and what are their formats. We are going to discuss it at this step. Then execution of the project. You need to check timely checking of the procedure. So while research is going on, you have to check at every step that how this research is taking place. So in execution of the project report, we just monitor the research. Analysis of data, raw data has already been collected. So on the basis of raw data, we usually convert into appropriate data. And on the basis of that appropriate data, we do data analysis. So there is a process. Means we usually start with editing, then coding, then classifying, and then tabulating. So these are the four steps which we usually carry out in analysis of data. In hypothesis testing, whatever assumptions we have made in the third step, we are going to match it with the conclusion. So we are going to test the hypothesis in this step with the conclusion. Testing hypothesis in this step. Generalization, whatever, after the finalization of confirmation of hypothesis, we are going to generalize and interpret the data, and finally we are going to write a report in a particular format which we usually follow while writing a report. So these are 11 steps and you all are expected to learn it by heart. You have to learn it at any cost, and this particular question is going to be asked in a long answer type question. I'm going to cover it one by one. That means the step number one, step number two, step number three, step number four, step number five. For each step, one separate lecture video would be there. So on the next lecture, I'm going to cover formulation of research problem, and I'm going to cover every step in separate lecture videos. So thank you so much for watching.